worst the worst, bitch.
So first up for Senator Lena Taylor, the question reads, will black leaders ever change their mission? Statistically, 100 unarmed black men nationally a year, and less than 300 total, including armed, nationally, are shot. Yet 6,000 black-on-black homicides occur. Should they refocus the public protesting from the police to the local neighborhoods?
So the question is, will black leaders change their mission or perspective? I think the first thing I'm going to say is I'm not exactly certain what that means, because black leaders, there are several. I would argue that every mother and every father in our community, every pastor and every business owner are all leaders. I frankly think every one of you that's sitting in the audience is a leader. Let me start by saying that, because I believe that it's not just about quote unquote those that are elected. So I don't know what that means about will they change their perspective or their mission or what that means. I don't know what you mean when you're asking the question of black leaders. Because I think part of the issue is we're the ones we're waiting on. And I don't believe that. Let me back up and say that first. Let me also say that I don't know that there is one vision for black leaders, whoever they are. You know, we make up a spectrum of perspectives. So I'm not exactly certain what the concept of all black leaders needing to think alike means, or be under some vision. Now, if the concept of what's being asked is, will they change because the concentration need not be on the community police issues, if that's what I hear in the underlying of what you're saying or what's being asked, then, you know, I want to say this. I'm the mother of a 16-year-old who will be 17 this year, and I don't know where the time went. And he was running down the street to take a turkey to the neighbors. And he was stopped. And I was told he was stopped because there was a lot of activity, in particular, you know, theft and things along those lines that was happening in the community. And I'm not sure, I did check and I asked, had it been robberies of frozen turkeys? Because that's what he was carrying when he was stopped. The reason that individuals who are African American have some of the perspectives that they do in the community is because of their experience. The truth of the matter is, like it or not, we have a history of a pattern that happens for black boys, black men that have happened in this community. Like it or not, it is the reality. Whether it's an 80-year-old guy who told me about his story when he was 13, or whether it's my son's story now all these years later. I think the larger issue for me is not for us to start this forum, you know, talking about will individuals change their perspectives? Because I think we all get to have a perspective because it's from the lens we come from. It's from the experience we come from. And that's a very real experience. I think the question is, and as I said earlier, what will we do to move ourselves to a different place? And so for me, I'm not asking individuals to black leaders to have one mission or one thought process. I'm not asking them to change their focal point on community police relationships needing to be different. What I'm asking for, candidly, is for what I do my Pledge of Allegiance to be, which is liberty, ending with liberty and justice for all. I want that to be real. I want that to be real for people, all individuals who live in our community. And so, candidly, in order for, in my opinion, for individuals to feel different and to not concentrate on the issues that revolve around community police relationships, we have to create different experiences for people. Because in 2016, a new generation started feeling different about community police relationships in my son. And he's just one example.
Thank you, Lena.
How do you spell it? D-U-E-R-S-T.
Durst is the worst.
Durst the worst, bitch!
Try, bitch!